Hey, I'm Allie. Welcome to Little Hill Homestead. A lot of people, for their New Year's resolutions and stuff, are trying to do things like more sustainable or DIY stuff. And I wanted to show you something that is actually really easy to do and fits that need. So today I'm going to show you how to make a beeswax food wrap. They're awesome for wrapping sourdough, which is what we use it for, but you can also make smaller ones to wrap bowls with, or I've seen people do like half of a watermelon wrapped in it, stick it in the fridge. They're just made from 100% cotton and some beeswax. They are, you can lightly wash them just with some cold water and a little bit of dish soap. And when they start to not work right, you just add a little more beeswax, iron it back in, and you could just keep them going for years. So I thought today I would show you how to make one. So the first thing you're gonna need is, this is an 18 by 24 inch piece of fabric. If you go to like Joann's or even Walmart, they have these, they call them fat quarters. And this one came in a set with a couple other colors. They're like, if you wanna do a solid color, they're like $1.30 up to about $2. Just depends on the pattern you pick. Just make sure it's 100% cotton because they do sell some that are poly as well. We don't want that on our food. Pinking shears, which are like the little ones that have like the teeth on them. You need some of those. That's gonna keep your fabric from fraying. It's one of those words, right? So the first thing we're gonna do is take our pinking shears and trim all around the edge. You can be as neat as you want, go as quick as you want. I have always, like, these things are okay to use. I just never can get the teeth lined up to do the next row. I'm trying to go fast, so I'm just gonna do this as quick as I can because I don't want to keep you guys on here all day. Ooh. Just be careful of your fingers. Okay. So for this one, I'm gonna do a full fat quarter, 18 by 24. I found that to be the best size for doing sourdough loaves, which you guys know we make a lot around here. I forever was using Ziplocs. I've tried linen and cotton bags to keep my sourdough good. This is what I found, because of the little bit of beeswax on it, it keeps it moist, so they last a little bit longer. We also are gonna put some pine resin, however you wanna say it, in it. That allows it to get sticky so that it tacks to the other piece of fabric, and then it has a little bit of jojoba oil. But beeswax has like a preservative naturally built into it, and it helps this your bread stay good a little longer. This is horrible, I'm sorry guys. Okay, we made it. So I just brushed my scraps to the side. So I've now pinking sheared. You know what I mean. Okay, let me get those out of the way now. So what I have here, I have an old towel on the bottom. Then I have a cardboard box right here. That's to keep my counter from getting damaged. Then I took, because this is so wide, I had to do two pieces of parchment paper and I taped those down so they don't move. And then I have two more that I just did one seam of tape on the side right here so that it just holds everything in place. But the biggest thing is, because I'm gonna be ironing this on granite, I didn't want it to damage my counter. And this also, because it has wax and pine resin, however you say it, I'm gonna say it wrong every time. It gets waxy and sticky, and so you want things that you're okay with throwing away. Like I'm just using an old towel and a cardboard box. So I'm gonna roll my first layer of parchment back. So I still have another one here. I'm gonna lay out my fabric. And put it in there where it fits perfectly, and it's where I'm not going to be ironing on any of the shipping tape that I taped it down with. Okay. You need beeswax. You can buy it by a block and shave it with a cheese grater. I buy these little pellets. They're easy to melt down. You can find them like at Hobby Lobby and stuff in certain aisles. Just make sure they're food safe, because they do sell some that have stuff in them that you don't want to put in your mouth. So you kind of like sprinkle it everywhere. You want to be a little bit generous, because this needs to soak into all your fabric. Like I was saying, if this starts to like, if the beeswax starts to crack in a couple, like in a year or whatever, and you want to recondition it, you're going to do the same thing on your wrap, and then it'll just keep going as long as you keep reconditioning it. I haven't had to do that too many times, but all right. I feel like that's a good amount. I use beeswax too. We do some foraging, and we pick things that grow naturally in our yard, and we make salves with them. So I make a mosquito bite salve and some different stuff using goldenrod and different stuff that we find in the yard. I know it's a little other side of us, but maybe we'll bring you along on the ride for that another time. Okay, so I feel like I have a good amount of beeswax all over. The next thing you need is your pine rosin, and it comes in bigger chunks. I just took a piece of, I put it in a Ziploc bag. And I used a hammer, but I had wrapped a towel around it so that it would break easily, but it made it into a powder. So you need a little bit of this. You don't want to overdo it, but this is what's going to make it stick when you go to fold your fabric on itself, basically. So I'm kind of just sprinkling, or like at 2 teaspoons. This is a huge wrap, by the way. I'm going to show you how to make a little bit smaller one too, but I did have to get this on Amazon. I couldn't find it anywhere locally. That's not true. I did find one place locally that sold it, a music store, because it's what they use on violin bows. So if you want to go that route, you can. Okay, the last thing we need is jojoba oil. It's food safe, and it's gonna mix in with this and make this more pliable so your beeswax does not crack. So we're gonna just dot kind of here, there, and everywhere. I think it's probably gonna be about 4 or 5 droppers of this. Like I said, this thing is massive. Most food wrappers are much, much smaller. I should have added up the cost of what it cost me to make up my own versus what it cost to buy them, because I was looking at these just for ideas on like Etsy and stuff. And they go up to like $35 a wrap for this size. My guess is I made this for under 10 bucks. Definitely made it for under 10 bucks. Okay. So we have all of our stuff that we need on here. We've got our beeswax, our jojoba, and our pine. Now, if you're allergic to the pine, you can leave it out. If you want to use a wrap, though, it's not going to stick to itself correctly. So you're going to have to use rubber bands or stuff to get it to hold. But it's what adds the tack. Okay, I'm going to fold my parchment paper. I'm tipping my iron to make sure it's hot. They turn off if you wait too long, you know? Okay. Now I have my iron on the hottest, which is like cotton linen, I think. Linen and cotton. And you're just going to put your iron on here and just give it a couple seconds. I had a big clump of beeswax in this corner, so that might take a little bit longer, but you'll see. As you're ironing, it starts to look wet. And when you move your iron around, I will say I'm using a really old iron. I ended up having to replace it because the heat didn't quite get as high as I wanted it to anymore. But it seems to be working. We're good. So you can see over here, you're starting to be able to, that's hot. See the fabric coming through. So that this video is not forever and a day long, I'm going to pause you guys and bring you back once I've ironed the whole thing and everything's kind of done, because this probably will take me about 5 minutes to get this pushed together and ironed. Okay, let me show you on this corner kind of what, so you can see what I'm dealing with. If I do leave my iron in place, it's going to melt that beeswax. You'll be able to see it start seeping out the sides of the parchment paper. And then I kind of just move it around a little bit to make sure it's infused into all the corners and edges of that fabric. So you see how now it's showing and this isn't? That's what you're going to do the whole way around. I should have started at the front, I guess, for you guys. Sorry. Okay. Now we're going to move it around. And you can see the beeswax through the parchment enough to be able to tell if all of your fabric is saturated or not. Okay, I'm gonna finish doing the rest of this and I'll be right back. Okay, I now have ironed the whole thing. As I was ironing, I'm pushing it towards the edges, and once I see the wax come all the way to the edge, I'm stopping. But I wanna make sure that the whole thing is good and saturated. And you'll see it start to, you can see when you get to an edge. If you get wax on your iron, by the way, if you just set it on a paper towel absorbs the wax out of it and you're good to go again. Okay, we are good. I'm gonna slowly peel this back. Once the air hits it, it cools pretty quickly, so. Okay, I have a pocket up here that I wanna get rid of really quick. You'll see, like, as you're doing it, you want it to stay warm so that you don't have like funky little pieces when you go to pull it up. Makes it easier to detach if it's warm. Okay. Like I said, this is gonna be easier with a small one, but we're going big today, so it is what it is. All right. I'm gonna heat this edge up a little bit so that I can get that parchment to unstick a little bit. All right, here we go. Remember, this is hot, it is wax. But I'm gonna peel back. It's already starting to harden, so it's gonna get a little more difficult. But. Okay. I should tell you, if you use a fabric that has white in it, my beeswax has some yellow to it, and so it's gonna change the color a little bit. You want to look to make sure you have beeswax on the entire surface. If you still see anywhere on your fabric that it's not, put your parchment back down. And then re-iron it a little bit more. But ours is good. I'm just going to lift this whole thing up slowly. And then some of that will just fall off. You kind of want to wave it in the air. The cool air is what's going to instantly cool it. And that beeswax is going to harden right back up. Already getting there. Like that stuff at the bottom, we'll be able to just peel that off. But it's already getting cool to the touch. It's still pliable because it is warm, but I'm gonna go down this edge and just kind of peel some of that off. If you want to as well, you can go back with your pinking shears and hit that edge. I've seen people do that too, where they do the pinking shears after, so you have a nice clean edge. It doesn't matter either way. I don't like to get the wax on the pinking shears, so. Okay. So there is our beeswax wrap. I do have wax on my fingers, but it's okay. But I'm gonna show you guys, let me set this one to the side, and I'm gonna show you guys one more, and then I'll show you it in action. But I wanna make a smaller one for you guys. So I'm gonna just set this back here where it can cool a little bit more. It's still just a touch warm. So I wanted to make a second one that's smaller, and I like to do a few at a time while I have all this out. Some of the wax that's on here is gonna absorb into the new one anyways, but I just had a piece of scrap that I cut into a circle. I've already picking sheared the edge of this one, so I'm gonna just put that back down. I'm gonna show you how quick this is when it's only one layer versus this big mamba jamba that we had before. So I got my beeswax. Same thing. Beeswax your fabric. This one I think will be pretty because it doesn't have any white in it. It's just got pinks and yellows, so I think it's gonna end up being really pretty. I've done a teal. Like I said, it does change the color just slightly. I've done a teal. Black would be good because it would just kind of stay the same. Navy would be good. Again, a couple spoonfuls of our pine rosin. I've always said rosin because I played the violin when I was a kid and I thought it was rosin then, but then when you look it up, it's spelled rosin. So I think it's rosin. Okay, that's plenty. And then our jojoba oil. There's not exact ingredients, like measurements. Just kind of make sure your fabric's covered. This one probably has a little too much on it, but it doesn't hurt to have too much. It just soups out the side anyways. All right, there's our jojoba oil. And this time I'm just gonna fold half down so you can see it a little bit better. It's not really pan is still hot, and we're gonna go in. And like I said, I don't know, you can't see it, but you can see the wax start to seep out the sides. You see it, like the liquid move. That's how I know when it's ready to ship to the next area. I did this beeswax pretty thick, but you also can feel when it's not bumpy in that area anymore, you know you're good to move. I guess I probably should have started with a small one because the video would have been much shorter for you guys. I'm gonna fill you with like beeswax now. I've got frays of fabric. Okay. We're about halfway there, you guys. So what I like to do is kind of measure some of my favorite bowls that I know I want one of these for, or common items. Like we use avocados a lot. So I measured enough, like fold the fabric around the avocado and then know exactly how much fabric I need. Then I pinking shear the edge of it and make them. It forms an awesome little barrier. It keeps things fresh. And like I said, it's completely reusable. In our house, we use Ziplocs, everybody does, but we try to use a lot of mason jars in our house for storage purposes or things that we can reuse like this. But do you see how like it changes color and now you can see it? Like, because it got wet, basically. Okay. That one went nice and fast. But I did get wax on this, so I'm gonna put the paper towel on it later. Suck it back off of there. Okay. This one is definitely good and stuck to it. All right, this one is definitely easier to work with, and I'm not gonna get that funky edge because I was able to pick it up quicker and it didn't totally. Ooh. Okay, seriously? This is hot on my hands, by the way, sorry. Oh, I'm smoking on my iron over here from this. Like I said, you just wing it back and forth a little bit, that'll cool it off. It also gets the excess drip down here, but I'm gonna get another piece of fabric and do another one and use all this residual wax that I have left because there's enough down there already to do another one. And it already has my pine and everything mixed in it. So I'll just throw the fabric on there and let it absorb it. Okay. It's so strange because it feels like a plastic tablecloth kind of when it's done. But, okay. So that's it. It's already cooling. Isn't that neat? That one turned out kind of pretty. It got a lot darker, but okay, let me show you. Really quickly. This is the one that we already made. See how it's like now stiff from our beeswax is totally dried. You store these in a flat drawer. You can fold them. You just wanna be careful not to have too many creases. It's actually better if you have an old wrapping paper tube to roll them around the wrapping paper tube and then stick it like on top of your refrigerator or something for storage. You don't wanna fold them up like you would a towel. But let me show you, I made a loaf. This is our sourdough. We actually finally got a grain mill for Christmas. We've been saving for it for a really long time and we got it. And this is our first loaf that we made with our whole wheat berries. This is white berry and kamut, I think is what it's called. But I just wanted to show you guys. So if you fold it on there, I fold both sides together. Good. The warmth of your hand is what's going to cause it to stick to itself. And then I fold up these edges a little bit. And just use the heat of your hands to basically make it stick to itself. This one has a lot of wax on it. I should have done a little less wax, but it's okay. See, so it sticks to itself. It's perfectly wrapped. This is a good size for sourdoughs or artisan breads. And then let me show you. Our other one I made to fit on some of these littler Pyrex pieces. But all you're gonna do is if you wanna use it on a bowl, you just fold it over the edge. And they're not like airtight. You can kind of fold the wax. Again, use the heat of your hands to kind of get it to stick to itself. All right, so then we have our little bowl covers. It kind of just will pop back on, but for like outside or something, it's the perfect little bowl cover. So I think that's it, you guys. But these are our beeswax wraps. They're sustainable. Oh, if you need to if you get food or something on them, run under cold water, because if you run it under hot, you're gonna lose all that wax. But run under cold water and just take a little sponge and wipe it down, and then just let it air dry. But then again, if it gets to where you're like, oh no, it's running out of beeswax or it cracks really bad, you do the same thing we just did. Put it on here, add a little more on top of it, iron it back out. So those are our beeswax wraps for today. And I hope that you guys can make one. They're pretty easy. And like I said, best thing is they're reusable. So go make one. If you guys have any other requests of things you want us to make for you, or just comments, just leave them below. We love to hear from you. Thanks so much for watching.